is the pre-processor interface for STKO OpenSees. At the top in blue, you will see the main toolbar. The Home tab houses the basic file commands, editing the view, and work plane commands. The Geometry tab has commands relevant to geometries, as does the Interaction tab, the Property tab, the Condition tab, the Mesh tab, and finally, the Analysis tab has the commands for running an analysis. As you can see, the drop-down menus along the upper left-hand side of the preprocessor contain the same commands that are available on the main toolbar and are organized in a very similar way. Should the user wish to view the manual or other program information, this can be viewed under Help. Moving on, the Worktree panel contains all hierarchical information about the models and is on the left-hand side. Opening the Physical Properties section will show the physical properties. Right-clicking on an item in the Worktree will open a menu. The commands present in the menu depend on the item type. The items in the Worktree are arranged hierarchically, and this can be seen by scrolling up and down. Simultaneously holding down Control and the mouse wheel will rotate the view around the object. The user can manipulate this to view their model from many different angles. The user can choose which property colors to view by using the Color by command on the main toolbar. Clicking the properties in the Worktree panel will show their colors. The terminal panel contains two text editors. The first one shows the output messages, and the second one is for user inputs. This is the Show Hide Faces section in the Quick Access toolbar. If you unselect all views, the geometry will disappear. You can then click Show Edges to show the edges on the model. You can also choose to view different conditions, show the faces, or show the points, depending on what you wish to see. The user can also use this panel to select the views, grid, zoom, and choose what parts of the geometry to select. Should the user click on overlapping items, a pop-up window will appear to allow them to select the desired item. This is the post-processor interface. After loading a database, click the Plot tab and Deformed Shape on the main toolbar. This will create a deformed shape of your model. In the Worktree panel, click New Plot Group Deformed Shape to open the editor window. It allows the user to modify the info, data, and visualization of the deformed shape and set the deformation scale. Clicking Surface Plot on the main toolbar and clicking the newly created Surface Plot on the Worktree panel will open a similar editor. The first part of the panel contains the information. The second part holds the different editable data that can be selected by the user. The next section is the Color Map section, where the user can set the colors to be used in color mapping. The user can select what elements they wish to see by checking boxes in the Visualization section. Changes made using the editor will be automatically reflected in the render window. Delete the surface plot by right-clicking it on the Worktree panel and selecting Delete. A volume plot can be created following the same steps. Notice that the main toolbar is much simpler than in the preprocessor and contains visualization commands and allows the user to manipulate chart data. To record an animation, click the New Plot group in the Worktree panel. The editor panel will open, showing the info, relevant commands, and the animation information. The user can create animated simulations of their model, like in the example below. Thank you.